Well, hello everyone, and as you can see, I'm using my mobile phone again. Also, as you can probably see, I'm looking quite red and sweaty because I've just come back from the gym. So I thought, it's been too long since I've been waiting to do this gazillion step skincare routine, and I've been finishing off my other products so that, you know, don't open new products before I finish the old ones. But that's it, I can't hold it anymore. So today is going to be the day that I'm gonna have a million things, stuff, products put onto my face. So let's go and see how this goes. Right, so first things first, and as you see, I have taken my contacts off, so this is gonna be interesting once I take my glasses off because I can't see a thing. So first, we're gonna go with the vanilla, as I call it. And, ooh, smells nice. So, yeah, I think I've explained that I've got all these products, I've just been wanting to try these forever. And I do want to do a proper review on them, like how it goes along, but I also thought it would be quite fun to do a first impressions on all of them, because I always think it's fun to watch. So I thought, yeah, why not? Oh, it smells lovely. I almost put it in my mouth though. Ooh. Oh, it's like a paraffin wax. Oh, it smells like even smells citrusy, I think. It has this like waxy appearance, sort of candle-like. Okay, so I'm gonna rub this in my face and then wash it with water, and then we'll see. I don't really have a lot of makeup today, but I couldn't wait anymore. I just couldn't. Right, so, okay. I have to put my glasses on each time I do this because I really can't see a thing without them. So you see my face is still wet, so I put it in my hand, rubbed it a little bit, put it across, and then washed it off. I did not open my eyes during the process, so I didn't quite realize. You can probably see there's still some makeup a little bit left over. So okay, I thought it would take everything out, but this is a bloody damn mascara. Or maybe I just didn't use the right amount. I guess I'll have to get used to these things. So next, for the water cleanser with the Neogen green tea. Let me get the bottle. Here it is. This is going to be the next step. Can you see the tea leaves? I think this camera, I can focus better on the close-ups. Okay, so with my face still wet, I'm gonna try this. Let's see how this goes. Okay, so now I've washed with the other one, and I think there's like hardly anything left. I think there might be a couple of dots, and I think it's because I didn't use enough of the oil cleanse, because this is more the oily, but it's left my face like super smooth and not stretched at all, and it smells really, really nice. So yeah, I quite enjoyed this so far. And right, next, exfoliant. Yeah, this is the Skin Food Sugar Black Sugar Mask Wash Off. So I think the idea is that I put this in my face and then I rub it a little bit, and then I leave it for a while, a while-ish. I might need to read. And then I've heard some people, then they jump into the shower and then, yeah, take this during the shower so that it's a lot. Ooh, smells lovely. Smells lemony again. Do I smell lemon on everything today? No, this is definitely lemon. This is lemon. The other one, I'm not sure. Could have been papaya? This is lemon. I'm sure it says lemon here somewhere. Uh-huh. So, right. Let's go for this. I'm back. I'm in this gate now. So I had the mask. It feels really, really rough. So I was almost a little bit scared. So I was really, really gentle. My skin feels so soft, so smooth. It's unbelievable. Like, wow. I mean, you can see all the little spots I have and stuff, but yeah, smooth. But yeah. So now we start going to the hydration part, I think. So that was the cleansing part, and now we're gonna start putting stuff to absorb. So the first one is this thing that's the toner. Again, very clear instructions at the back. Right, okay, so give me a second. I'll just gonna try and see how this goes. So next is time for the essence. I have to admit, I really like this packaging of Time Revolution. It looks like super sleek and expensive. So yeah, I'm gonna do the same of putting a few drops and then go for it. Drop. Jesus. Okay. Ooh. Again, no odor really. I've seen some people do that of warming it in their hands. So I'm doing the same with everything. I don't know if I'm supposed to do it everything, but I'm just tapping. And to be honest, my skin once again is like and absorbing all of this. I guess I wouldn't think that my skin would be absorbing so much liquid. It's feeling a bit tacky, this one, I think. Yeah. I'm looking forward to see this video afterwards, considering that I cannot see that because my eyes. So next we move to the ampoule. So here it is, again, beautiful packaging. And okay, maybe I should put this directly on my face, which means I'll do that off camera and then come back and pat it in. Yeah, I think I'll do that. So I can't see if I do it here, and I don't want to mess this up, so I'll be right back. Definitely a little bit more viscous, which is something that I had heard of, that you go from the more watery to the more viscous one. And this definitely, yeah, I feel like I massage it in. Hopefully that's what I'm supposed to do. Yeah, this one's definitely tacky, leaving my face quite tacky. Like, if I compare it to the serum of the Elizabeth Arden, the Advanced Night Repair, that one does not leave my my face tacky at all. And this is where I've seen some contradictory, I think, information, which is that you're supposed to do the face mask after this. Some people say, well, the face mask is basically a serum, so why would you do the two in one go? And I guess I can kind of see it. And to be honest, to me that makes sense. If the mask is serum embedded, why would you do this and the mask when you only do the mask two or three times a week, and you only, in the same way that you only exfoliate like two or three times a week. So I don't know, should I do the mask or should I just go straight ahead for the, I kind of feel like I'm cheating if I don't do the mask, because I kind of feel that should be one of the steps. I've also heard that actually Korean people do not do 10 steps, and that's something that someone has invented for the Western world and blah blah. I can kind of imagine. Yeah. So I think that I'm gonna be, considering it's 10:30, I'm gonna be a rebel and I'm not gonna do the mask. I'm gonna do the eye cream and the face cream. Okay, so just in the time of picking up the creams, actually the tackiness is gone. So actually it's not, yeah, it just absorbed really nicely. For the eye cream, I've got the Snail from Amazon. Gonna do all of these on camera, like all of you. Ooh, do not move the camera. By camera, she means phone. I probably should have tried to open this, like, not in the video, because I really would like my videos to be under 10 minutes. Like, because these parts are the parts that you want to skip through. And if I had any knowledge on how to do video stuff, of course I would cut this, but I'm gonna go offline and do this and then I'll come. just as I was trying to open this thing just jumped all of a sudden, and because there was cream on the top part, now there's cream in my finger. So I'm just gonna try not to, I forget that the microphone's right there, so each time I put a cream there, you're gonna hear everything, sorry. So I am just going to put my glasses down, and yeah, this is not the right finger, this is already not going as it should. God, I've got like cream all over my fingers, and I'm just patting it with not the right finger again. How can I get the wrong finger twice? I'm just patting this. Smells alright actually, although I'm not sure what did I expect as a smell, but okay. Just patting and patting away. Right. For a gazillion hours because I probably had too much cream because it went to my fingers, and now Rebel Me again is not using the face cream of Green Beauty because I already had purchased these ones, and these ones are the caviar cream. Yeah, it smells nice. I like it more than the one that I was using before, which was the Dr. Botanicals. If I compare texture wise, because one of the things that I didn't quite like, I guess, was because it wasn't thick and oily. Like, it just felt like not enough for a night cream. And this one is just, you know, it's a gel, but it feels a bit more moisturizing. And my skin felt amazing. Right, I'm just going to close this thing completely, and then I'm going to come back with my glasses. So now that it's all absorbed, and yeah, like quite a bit still went for my neck, which is nice. So my skin is feeling super soft and super nice, like very velvety. And so are my fingers, I guess, because they've been applying all this stuff. Yeah, very nice. So yeah, this was my first routine. Cheating on the mask thing, although possibly not. And yeah, I guess I'll continue doing this, and then I'll update you guys on how it's going and also how often I'm doing it, because like I said, I don't think realistically I'm gonna do this day, like morning and night. I think my morning routine will be considerably shorter. But yeah, and then we'll see how my skin is coming along, because, well, even though I don't have like huge amount of, well, I have some wrinkles here, but not, I'm gonna say not horrible, okay? Not horrible. They're made basically because I smile a lot and I'm very, very expressive. Oh my God, that was scary. So yeah, but other than that, I have like my freckles, I've got some bits of redness, but to be honest, I don't think I can complain too much. I never really had acne, so I don't really have the scarring that some people have. So all I have is mainly aging things that, yeah, and also stuff that I can blame myself. Like over the years, although I do take my makeup off almost every single time. Yeah, I mean, maybe I've not put cream every night. I don't know what I'm saying, it's late, I'm tired, and I'm gonna go to bed now. But yeah, bye.